Welcome to the Best Coast Shire Council Report, your weekly update on council news and events.
Hi, I'm Lauren Grills.
And I'm Steve Fury.
Welcome to this week's show. This week we have some updates on the Wonthaggi Union Cinema and Arts Centre, how to have your say on the Playspace strategy, the Southern Gippsland Food Map, but first it's time to clear your home of unwanted chemicals.
That's right, Lauren. The annual Detox Your Home program is coming to Wonthaggi on Saturday the 13th of August, and it will be held from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Each year we get together with Sustainability Victoria, and we ask you to collect up your unwanted items like pesticides, detergents and weed killers and give them to us.
Of course, this is the easiest and safest way to dispose of these chemicals, not to mention it's totally free. Thinking about your pets and kids, many of these items can be dangerous if left around your home, and they could even add extra fuel to a house fire, and the CFA's job is dangerous enough. The other good thing about disposing of these chemicals with this program is that they're recycled for recovery instead of ending up in landfill.
Or worse, down the drain, where they could harm animals, vegetation, rivers, and ultimately the beaches that we all enjoy, when it's warmer, of course. The program is funded by the Victorian Landfill Levy, so please have a look around your house or shed, and if you find things like acids, antifreeze, fertilisers, coolant, paint stripper, pool chemicals, or rat poison, then bring them along to the Wonthaggi Transfer Station, 180 Cameron Street, on the 13th of August, from 10 till 1. You'll find the full list of what you can and can't bring at sustainability.vic.gov.au/detoxyourhome.
Moving on, we've been working closely with the current Wonthaggi cinema operator, Keith Stevens, who is retiring in October this year. By mid to late August, we're planning to share the recommendations of the business case that explores the needs of our very active arts and cultural community. In particular, the business case looks at the centre's capacity and the future programming needs.
Now, we certainly understand the needs of the arts and film community, and the business case reflects the diverse nature of how the centre is used. We're continuing to work through all the options available to improve the programming needs of the centre and understand the importance of the film within it. So stay tuned, mid to late August we'll see that business case released.
If you take a look around Bass Coast, not only will you see beautiful coastlines, but you'll see a huge number of farms. In fact, agriculture makes up a large percentage of our local economy. Listeners may not know, but we're really fortunate to have some of these farms selling their produce at the farm gate. The question is, how do you find them?
Well, that question's been answered by the website southerngippslandfoodmap.com.au. This is a map-based website that shows you where our best local produce can be purchased from, and some are from the very farms where the produce has grown. This is a joint project between us and the South Gippsland Shire Council, and it's just a brilliant tool to show off the best of the whole region. It stretches from the Phillip Island Winery in Ventnor all the way to the Tura Heritage Pear Orchard. And Lauren, did you know there's even a garlic farm in Crow Era?
No, I didn't, Steve, so that proves that it's a great website for locals as well as tourists. So next time you're thinking about doing a foodie road trip through Bass Coast and South Gippsland, plan your trip at the southerngippslandfoodmap.com.au. And if you're a local producer and you haven't heard of it before, you can also list your business on the food map site for free with no ongoing costs.
Still on the topic of leisure, we've released a draft Playspace strategy for everyone to comment on. First of all, it might be an unfamiliar term to some folks, so we should define what a Playspace is. The term doesn't just include playgrounds or the equipment, but it's any open public space for play, like parks where you can kick a footy or throw a frisbee. These are areas that council maintains or a community organisation looks after on our behalf.
This strategy will help guide decisions on play spaces for the next 10 years in Bass Coast. There's a fair amount of research and public consultation that has already been done over the last several months, and it lists all our current play spaces and who looks after them. The strategy also lists the design standards around what kind of play spaces suit different areas of the Shire, and also lists statements of their life cycle, maintenance and renewal.
You can download the draft Playspace Strategy 2016 to 2026 from our website at basscoast.vic.gov.au/play, or get one from any of our customer service centres. And please forward any comments by the 29th of August to strategicplanningadmin@basscoast.vic.gov.au, or by mail to PO Box 118 Wonthaggi 3995.
A couple of reminders before we go. The next community engagement session is next week on Wednesday the 10th of August at 3 p.m. in the Council Chamber at the Civic Centre in Bellevue Street, Wonthaggi. This is a chance to present and or provide your comments on business currently before Council, including the current meeting agenda.
And the Stand for Council information sessions are only a few weeks away, so if you're thinking of stepping up to represent your community, you should really get along to one of them to find out more. Head to the official website standforcouncil.com.au and click the yellow box on the right titled Briefing Sessions, and you'll see the details for the Bass Coast sessions on the 22nd, 23rd and 25th of August.
Thanks, Steve. That's it for this week, but as always, if you have any questions or need more information about any anything we've mentioned, give us a call on 1300 B-Coast. That's 1300 226 278 or 03 5671 2211. You can also keep up to date on facebook.com/Bass Coast Shire. Follow us on Twitter on @BassCoast and on Instagram @BassCoastShire. Catch you next week for more council news.
The Bass Coast Shire Council Report is broadcast on Tuesday mornings at 9:30, Thursday afternoons at 4:30, and on Saturday mornings at 10 on your community station 3MFM. Audio and transcript is also available from our website, basscoast.vic.gov.au.